This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to find the slant asymptote of rational functions. Slant asymptotes are also called oblique asymptotes. Slant asymptotes occur when you've got a rational function and the degree of the polynomial in the numerator is one greater than the degree of the polynomial in the denominator. So for example, if we have f of x equals x squared plus 2x minus 8, that's a second degree polynomial, and that's over x plus 1, a first degree polynomial, we'll get a slant asymptote. Another example might be g of x equals x to the fourth minus 5, that's a fourth degree polynomial. The denominator has 2x to the third plus 3x plus 4, a third degree polynomial. Once again, the degree in the numerator is one greater than the degree in the denominator. Graphs might look something like this. Since it's a rational function, you're going to have one or more vertical asymptotes. But instead of a horizontal asymptote, you're going to have an asymptote which is a slanted line, an oblique line. And the graph of the function will get closer and closer to that line as x approaches negative infinity and positive infinity. But since it's an asymptote, it will never actually touch that line. To find the slant asymptote, the process is fairly simple. All you do is divide the denominator into the numerator and disregard any remainder that you might have. So let's see some examples. Here I've got f of x equals 2x squared plus 2x minus 9 over x plus 3. So this will give me a slant asymptote. I can do these problems with either synthetic division or long division. This one would be pretty easy with synthetic division. So I'll set up the synthetic division problem. I'm going to take the coefficients in the numerator. That's a 2 and a 2 and a negative 9. And I want to divide that by negative 3. The denominator was x plus 3. I want to take the constant that the denominator had and change its sign. Okay, so I bring down that 2, multiply negative 3 times 2. That gives me a negative 6. I add 2 plus negative 6 is negative 4. Then I multiply negative 3 times negative 4. I get a positive 12. Add negative 9 and positive 12, and I get a 3. That's going to be my remainder. I don't care about the remainder. I care about this 2 and the negative 4, so I'll turn that back into a polynomial. That's 2x minus 4, so that's going to be the slant asymptote, or the oblique asymptote, for this function. Okay, let's do one with long division. This is f of x equals negative 6x squared plus 5x plus 8 divided by 3x plus 2. And this would be easier to do with long division since we have that 3x over here in the denominator. Okay, so let's set this up for long division. That's 3x plus 2 divided into the numerator, which was negative 6x squared plus 5x plus 8. I want to divide the 3x into the negative 6x squared. That'll be negative 2x. Multiply negative 2x times 3x is negative 6x squared. Negative 2x times 4 is negative 4x. I subtract. The x squared terms will cancel out. I've got 5x minus negative 4x. Well, that's going to be a positive 9x. Bring down the 8, divide 3x into 9x, that would be 3. 3 times 3x is 9x, 3 times 2 is 6. I subtract, get a remainder of 2. I don't care about the remainder. My slant asymptote is going to be negative 2x plus 3, the result of the division without the remainder. Okay, so basically, just to repeat this one more time, all you do to find the slant asymptote is divide the numerator of the rational function by the denominator, disregard any remainder you have. That will give you the slant asymptote. Okay? Take care. I'll see you next time.